Hello students, here we have been learning very interesting paper 6, that is computational botany. From this computational botany we have been learning related with second unit, sample and sampling. Students, we have to learn today the types of a random sampling. What is random sampling and its types? So here we have been learning types of a random sampling. First one is a systematic random sampling. So this is the type of a random sampling. Which one is a systematic random sampling? In case of systematic random sampling, there is a gap or interval between each selected unit in the sample. So there is a gap, isn't it? The process systematic random sampling is that there is a gap or interval between each selected unit in the sample. First one. Again, selection of unit on a sample interval k starting from determined point where k is equal to capital N divided by small n. The number, the units on your frame from 1 to n. You have to number the units to your frame from 1 to n. Then determine the point, the random start. Afterwards, kth must be drawn until the total sample has been drawn. Now, actually, what is this systematic random sampling? So, with the example, we will see here. Suppose, if we have a population of a 500 individuals, kithe aahet aplyakade total population madhe, that are the 500, and we want to sample of 500 divided by 50. In the sense, we want to take out the sample of a 50, then 500 divided by 50, so every 10th sample, we will choose every 10th sample subject or object from the population. If you have got this idea, I will give you example. Suppose in our garden, mango garden, we want to study the 500 mango plants, isn't it? We want to study the 500 mango plants, but just to individually visit to each and every plant, and then we have to study and then we have to conclude, that is a tedious method. It requires more money. Again, it would be a not fast method. So here what we have to do, out of that 500 total plant, how many plants we want to study in systematic random sampling method? So 50. We want to select the sample of a 50 mango plant from 501. Now that 500 total population divided by the number of sample, that is a 50. So what would be exact calculation of that one? 10. So out of that 500 plant, every 10th mango plant we have to select for the study. So researcher will have to visit every 10th plant, isn't it? Every 10th plant there we have to visit. So when such a type of a sampling method is there, that is a random but systematic random sampling, isn't it? Systematically we have selected the sample, and that is the systematic random sampling method. Now what are the exact merits of this systematic random sampling? Why we have to go with, or why we have to use or applied this systematic random sampling. So because that systematic random sampling having some merits, advantages. First advantage is that this is a simple method and convenient. These two points, two words gives us idea about first merit of a systematic random sampling. That is, this method is a simple and convenient. Second one, time and work is reduced. You might be understood. Just 1 minute back, I said to you, suppose we are having a 500 mango plants in our field and we want to study those plants, isn't it? We want to study those plants, or simply we want to measure the height of 500 plant, but it will require a more time, isn't it? Again, more work we have to do for that one, isn't it? But if we will follow systematic random sampling method, then it will reduce the time and work. So this is the second merit, we have to say that, of a systematic random sampling. Another, if proper care is taken, result will be accurate. So systematic random sampling, why we have to apply, why we have to use? For the analysis, or for the reaching up to the conclusion, or for the study of a population. Another most important merit is that it can be used in infinite population. Population is a huge one, then also we can use this systematic sampling method. So friends, systematic random sampling method is having its merits. That is, it is a simple and convenient. It reduces time and work. The results whatever we get from this, that one will be the 100% accurate, and again it can be applied, used in a huge size, infinite population. Now, although such a type of a merits are there, two limitations are there of random systematic sampling. First one is that it never represents whole population. The sampurna population la represent karat nahi. Another thing is that there is a chance of a personal bias of the investigator. Jo samshodhan karnara, jo study karnara tya pashyantacha, to bias asu shakto, isn't it? Ani sagya mhanje apan 500 paiki 50 select kele, ते 50 हे सगळ्या पॉप्युलेशनला रिप्रेझेंट करत नाहीत. सो दीज टू आर द डीमेरिट्स, लिमिटेशन्स ऑफ अ रँडम सिस्टमॅटिक सॅम्पलिंग. नाउ वी हॅव लर्न टाइप ऑफ random sampling, that was systematic. Now another type we have to learn, that is of a stratified, isn't it? Which one? Those stratified random sampling. So in case of random sampling, there are the main two types which we have studied just now, that was a systematic random sampling, and right now we have to study stratified, second one, that is stratified random sampling. So friends, what is this stratified? Strata means what? They're actually layer, kiwa thar apan mhanu shakto, anek thar, it is a plural word. आणि स्ट्रॅटम दॅट इज अ सिंग्युलर वर्ड, एक एक थर असेल तर आपण त्याला स्ट्रॅटम म्हणतो, दोनपेक्षा जास्त असतील तर त्याला आपण स्ट्रॅटा म्हणतो, इजंट इट. इन केस ऑफ द स्ट्रॅटिफाईड रँडम सॅम्पलिंग द पॉप्युलेशन इज डिवायडेड इन टू होमोजिनियस म्युच्युअली एक्सक्लुसिव्ह सबग्रुप्स, होमोजिनियस बट म्युच्युअली एक्सक्लुसिव्ह सबग्रुप्स कॉल्ड ॲज अ स्ट्रॅटा, कॉल्ड ॲज अ स्ट्रॅटा. अँड द सॅम्पल इज सिलेक्टेड फ्रॉम ईच स्ट्रॅटम. नाव बिफोर गेटिंग टेलिंग टू यू अबाउट दिस पॉईंट आय विल गिव यू एक्झाम्पल. वी नो दॅट देर इज अ गनी बॅग विच इज फुल ऑफ जॉर सेल्स, इजंट इट, फुल ऑफ अ जॉर सेल्स. वेन वी गो टू द मार्केट फॉर सेलिंग दॅट गनी बॅग, इजंट इट, वेन वी आर गोइंग टू द मार्केट फॉर सेलिंग दॅट गनी बॅग, ॲट दॅट टाईम दॅट बिझनेसमन परचेसर टेक द सॅम्पल फ्रॉम ईच लेअर ऑफ द ॲटलीस्ट 3-4 लेअर ऑफ द गनी बॅग, टॉप देन नेक्स्ट टॉप देन मिडल वन देन नेक्स्ट मिडल अँड देन ॲट द बॉटम. सो फ्रॉम दॅट इट सॅम्पल टेक्स आउट अँड देन that fellow businessman decide or purchaser decides quality of a grains and then that fellow tells us the cost of a that gunny bag or 100 kg grains of jawar which we have taken into the gunny bag. So here what that fellow has done, that fellow has taken a homogeneous mutually exclusive subgroups from the population. Subgroup means that fellow has taken a small amount of a grains, isn't it? So in case of stratified random sampling, a population is divided into homogeneous mutually exclusive subgroups which is called as a strata, and the sample is selected from the each stratum. Teni pahilanda kay kela, selected strata kela and tya strata madhun thodo thodo sample ghetla, isn't it? So this type of a methodology is known as a collection of a sample method is known as a stratified random sampling. Now what is goal? To guarantee that all groups in the population are adequately represented. Pratyek tya population madhya group la representation karnyachi ya tikani sandhi. Within the stratum, tya stratum madhe kasa asla pahe uniformity, homogeneous one. Between the strata difference asel tar heterogeneous asel. That could be the heterogeneous. Am I right? Now, can be stratified by any variable. Kutlahi variables apan stratification karu shakto. For example, samjha apan manasancha group ghetla. Tyachyamadhye apan don group karu shakto. Male, female. Education, educated people cha group ghetla. Isn't it? Tyachyamadhye graduate, undergraduate. He heterogeneous zale. Graduate, homogeneous bajula kadla tyatna. An dusra homogeneous apan bajula kadla. Undergraduate. Pan doni madhye difference kay? That is heterogeneous. तिसरा आला अँड पोस्ट ग्रॅज्युएट, म्हणजे एज्युकेटेड माणसं आपल्याकडे असतील, पीपल्स आर विथ अस, सो वी कॅन डिवाइड इन टू ए 3 ग्रुप्स विच आर म्युच्युअली एक्सक्लुसिव्ह अँड होमोजिनियस वन. एक ग्रुप केला आपण ग्रॅज्युएटचा, एक केला अंडर ग्रॅज्युएट, अंदर अनदर वी हॅव मेड ऑफ ए पोस्ट ग्रॅज्युएट. नाव दिस एक्झाम्पल विल गिव यू आयडिया how to solve, because in the examination maybe there are examples. Here example is given, example of a 50 student. Sample of a 50 student is drawn from the population consisting of 800 students belonging to the two institution A and B. The number of students in the distribution A is 200 and number of students from the institution of B is 300. And how will you draw the sample using the proportional allocation? But we have to first of all understand exact which question is asked, isn't it? What they have allotted to us, they have told us they want a sample of a 50 student. They want a sample of a 50 students out of 800 students. Out of 800 student, but that 800 students are from two different institute, that is A institute and B institute, isn't it? They are one correction you have to made here. Here not a 800 is there, isn't it? Here is a total number of student is, again you have to keep in mind, only 500. So again I will tell you exact example is like that. We want to select a 50 students from 500 students, but that 500 students are from two different institute, that is A institute and B institute. From A institute actually 200 students are there in 500 student, and from B institute there are the 300 students from, there are 300 students from B institute. Is it clear to you? Total student sample we want 50, sample of a 50 student, and there are total 500 student. In that 500 student, 300 student from B institute and 200 student from A institute. Now we have to give a equal opportunity, equal allocation to the representation to the each institute, isn't it? So what we have to do, solution is given here. There are the two strata, don't strata in case with size, size number of students of which are kept, don't strata. Kutla strata at N1. N1 is equal to 200. N1 manje A institute che kiti vidyarthi 200. N2 is equal to 300. B institute che kiti 300. Total population is N. Isn't it? N is equal to N2. That is equal to N plus N2. That is equal to 500. Doni mun institute che vidyarthi kiti 500. The sample size kiti paise aplyala 50. So this formula we have to use. So N1 institute, N1 is the institute, tacha kiti vata asla paise, kiti proportion asla paise, how many students would be selected in that 50 group sample, 50 groups a sample hai tacha madhe kiti asle paise, tar N divided by N, small N divided by capital N. This is, this small n is nothing but the population or sample number which we want to draw. But the small n is equal to 50 and total population ki the 500, isn't it? Ani te institute che kiti vidyarthi ahet tyatun kiti 50 ya yene sathi tar 200, am I right? 200 गुणिले 50, 200 इंटू 50 किती झाले, 5 दुने दॅट कुड बी द 10,000, इजंट इट, दॅट कुड बी द 10,000 डिवाइडेड बाय 500. एक शून्य गेलं, दुसरं गेलं, हे गेलं, हे गेलं, म्हणजे राहिले किती, राहिले किती 50 गुणिले 200 बरोबर 5 दुने 10,000 भागिले 500, इजंट इट? सो दॅट कुड बी इक्वल टू द 200, सॉरी 20, दॅट कुड बी द इक्वल टू 20, इजंट इट? Once again I will tell to you, N1 is the sample which want to select from the A institute, that is equal to N divided by N into N1, manje kiti jale, N manje 50 divided by 500 into 10 institute madhe 200 vidyarthi hote, 200 madhun tya 50 madhe tyancha kiti vata asla paije, so finally kiti jale, 20 5 100, 20, isn't it? Have you got this idea about this calculation? Now, हे झालं एन वन म्हणजे ए इन्स्टिट्यूटमध्ये आपल्याला 20 मिळाले. आपल्याला टोटल सॅम्पल किती करायचा आहे? 50. कितीमधून काढायचं आहे? 500 काढायचं आहे. मग आता दुसरी जी इन्स्टिट्यूट आहे बी, त्याचं जर आपण कॅल्क्युलेशन करायचं म्हटलं तर मग काय करावं लागेल आपल्याला? सेम ॲज इट इज, इजंट इट? Here, N2 is equal to, again, N divided by capital N into N2, isn't it? म्हणजे किती झाले? पुन्हा N किती आहे आपल्याला? सॅम्पल कितीचं पाहिजे? 50. किती टोटल पॉप्युलेशन आहे? 500 विद्यार्थ्यांचं. गुणिले बी इन्स्टिट्यूटमधनं किती आले आहेत? तर 300. मग आता हे किती झाले? 15,000 भागिले 500. 10 हा 10, बरोबर आहे? हा 10 गेला. मग पाच एके पाच, पाच तारीख 15 राहिलेले 0 म्हणजे किती झाले? 30. सो फ्रॉम ए इन्स्टिट्यूट आउट ऑफ 200 वी हॅव टू टेक द 20 स्टुडंट्स इन नंबर ऑफ सॅम्पल दॅट इज 50, अँड फ्रॉम बी इन्स्टिट्यूट वी हॅव टू सिलेक्ट 30 स्टुडंट्स फ्रॉम 300. सो दिस इज द अलोकेशन. ओके, गॉट इट? यू हॅव टू सॉल्व दिस एक्झाम्पल सो यू विल कम टू नो दॅट. नाव मेरिट्स ऑफ ए स्ट्रॅटिफाईड सॅम्पलिंग मोर रिप्रेझेंटेटिव्ह. पहिलं मेरिट काय त्याचं? More representative, in the sense सगळ्यांचं representative. It ensures the greater accuracy as compared to our systematic random sampling. त्याच्यापेक्षा greater accuracy. Easy to administer, अतिशय easy आहे method, anybody can follow. Greater geographic concentration, reduce the time and expenses. कितीही मोठं geographically असलं तर त्याचं आपण रिड्यूस करू शकतो. In the sense मोठा area that we can divide into a mutually exclusive groups. म्हणून मोठ्या एरियामध्ये सो ॲप्लिकेबल आहे. When the original population is badly skewed, this method is appropriate for the non-homogeneous population sathi sudha aplyala he upayogi padte. These are the merits. Now limitations, jase adache advantage tase limitations are there. To divide the population into a homogeneous, that is a requires more money. Homogeneous मध्ये करायचं असेल तर त्या अनेक वील हॅव टू स्पेंड अ लॉट ऑफ मनी ऑन दॅट वन. सो इकॉनॉमिकली वी हॅव टू से दॅट कॉस्टली, दॅट यू कॅन राईट इकॉनॉमिकली कॉस्टली. इमप्रॉपर स्ट्रॅटिफिकेशन लीड्स टू द बाय. जर समजा स्ट्रॅटिफिकेशन व्यवस्थित झालं नाही, व्यवस्थित थर तयार केले गेले नाहीत, तर देअर कुड बी द ओव्हरलॅप. एकाचं दुसऱ्यात ओव्हरलॅप होऊन देअर कुड बी द प्रॉब्लेम टू द स्ट्रॅटा. सो दीज आर द टू लिमिटेशन्स. स्टुडंट्स, टुडे वी हॅव लर्न मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट टाईप्स ऑफ ए रॅन्डम सॅम्पलिंग. द टू टाईप्स, दॅट इज फर्स्ट वन इज ए सिस्टमॅटिक रॅन्डम सॅम्पलिंग, अनादर वन इज ए stratified random sampling. Also we have learned merits and limitations of these two types. Along with that one, we have solved one of the problem example. So what I suggest to you, you will have to prepare on your own examples and try to solve those. Make the practice makes man perfect. With this, I am having a confidence that you will do that job at your places. At least 10 to 15 examples you have to prepare on your own and try to solve those. That will help you to understand exact how to select the samples, how to give a justice to each and every group at the time of selection of a
sample. With this, thank you very much.